Hello. Good evening. Good night. Welcome back. We're here with our hats.
We're here with our
Monkey Islands. It is Tuesday night.
We're back on our bullshit, everybody.
We're back on our bullshit.
Yar.
Half playing a game and talking about food of the week or whatever.
Yes.
That's our bullshit.
We have no weird foods to sample today.
We don't, which is unfortunate. Actually, I do want a show.
No.
Okay, thank you.
Are you okay?
I'm okay, thank you. I do want to show off something that I've been obsessed with later on. I actually had one for dinner. It's been a weird day. I had one for dinner, but I'm going to show this momentarily and talk about
it's a white claw.
No, it's not. It would be... You don't just have one white claw, first of all. You're having white claws. And yeah, it'd be a very different weird kind of day if that was my dinner. But hey, Adventure Emma, that's you. You're Adventure Emma.
Yeah, hello, Assistant Rudy, that's you.
I'm Assistant Rudy.
You're watching the WebDM show that has nothing to do with role-playing games.
Yeah, sometimes you just want to hang out and shoot the shit and play a classic LucasArts adventure game, and that's what we're doing today.
What food are you showing us? Are you waiting?
I was going to wait, but do you want to jump in?
I can't take the anticipation. Okay. Right.
So I don't know if you've seen these before. They're called Bobo's Oat Bars, okay?
Is that like one of those like nutritional cookies?
So, it's more like you take oatmeal, you take rolled oats, and push them together with like sugar and brown rice syrup, and it's not quite a granola bar either though, because the texture is soft. If you push it in, it gives.
It sounds an awful lot like you're eating a rectangular cookie, Rudy.
They're cookie-esque, and that's partly why I love it. But it's more like an oatmeal-style cookie.
Okay. I love an oatmeal cookie.
I know. I love it, too.
Put a raisin in it. I'm fine with that.
So I had cinnamon raisin was the one I ate today. But they have chocolate chip. They have original. They have coconut. They have all sorts of different flavors. And I really like only 9 grams of added sugar. The rest is all rolled oats per serving, and it's two servings per bar. But if you need a quick pick-me-up or like a breakfast on the go at 340 calories, I love these.
Yeah. Hashtag not sponsored.
Not sponsored. But it also wanted me, I wanted to talk about another thing that unfortunately has gone extinct in the marketplace, which was there was a company called Munk Pack, which is a funny name. MUNKPACK. And they would do like you ever do overnight oats?
Yes. Those are very good.
I love overnight oats. And they would do essentially overnight oats in like a squeezy tube. Kind of similar to like applesauce often comes in those weird little pouches, I guess is a way to put it. But it was like oatmeal.
Yes, I have a child, so I'm intimately familiar with pouches of food.
Pouch of applesauce or what have you. So I
have a case of those in my house right now.
I'm jealous. All the applesauce you can eat. Sounds pretty good to me. but that was something that I really loved. Are we live? We are live, right?
Yeah, we're live.
We're live on the WebDM.
WebDM?
Okay, cool.
Just right here, sure. I'm watching.
Okay, cool. Just making sure, because I didn't get an email notification, so that's probably coming. But yeah, I love those too. Instead, Munk Pack, as a brand, as a company, pivoted to keto only stuff.
So no more oatmeal pouches.
No, those are not in the keto diet. So
like meat and butter pouch.
Yeah. Mm. Whoa, hey. Now you're talking my language. No, that sounds good though. I'd be into the meat and butter pouch.
Yeah. That's my body.
what are we all but meat and butter pouches at the end of the day? What is humanity but a crowd of meat and butter pouches?
Yes.
This I ask you, viewer.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's for you to answer for yourself, or answer us in chat.
Let's talk about game, because I'm lost.
Yeah.
So last time we went to Scab Island.
Yes, we need to get a costume.
Yes, so we met the governor, and while we were there, we found an invitation, I believe. Or we won an invitation through
means. Disgusting habit into a prestige-winning skill.
I don't want to talk to the spinning guy. So, what we need now to get into the mansion where the party is happening, where former wife, Governor Elaine Marley is, is a costume. They won't let us pass the guard kiosk without a costume.
Mm-hmm.
I have no idea how to get a costume. I played this game a while back. I'm sure it didn't make sense at the time, and I have no idea how to get it now. So I'm going to go to you, Adventure Emma, with your adventure manual.
My adventure manual. Give me a hint.
Let's do that. Let's do hints. Let's not just be like, do this.
Okay.
Because I think that's more fun.
There's that. There's that. You won the invitation. Okay. You need to get some money. Do you have any money?
We have a couple hundred. We have 399 pieces of eight.
Well, I think we need to gamble more so we get some more shit.
That's not fun, but okay, we can do that.
Gambling not fun? Blasphemy.
Gambling is not... I mean, it's very cliche to say this, but gambling is fun when you're winning and not fun when you're losing.
I've never lost, so I don't know what
that Have you played?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Well, then...
I played until I won, and then I never
Then your experience again. With gambling is...
Everybody...
Works within my theory, yes.
You should do it. Just keep trying. You'll win, and then you'll feel good.
No. We're not responsible for this kind of advice.
No. No, don't take advice from a Twitch stream where people play Monkey Island. And...
That's so Twitch gambling streams are really popular. I don't know if you know that.
That feels like it should be against the law, but I can see why people would like it. Like, I used to love watching like the poker tournaments and stuff like
that.
Sure,
but this is like a guy goes to a slot website and puts like $1,500 in and just slots for an hour and a half.
I would watch the shit out of that.
My parents love that on YouTube. They just watch people playing slots. I'm like, I guess I get it. Oh, I'm all fuzzy there. I don't get it. Like,
I've TikTok. I have issues with TikTok algorithm because it gets me on weird shit a lot, and I get stuck on it. And one of the things I got stuck on at one point was like those gambling machines where it's like a bunch of big pile of quarters and a pusher.
Oh, I know those. So I know those because of my Dave and Buster days. And yes, I do have Dave and Buster days, as I would put it.
Well, don't we all?
The coin pushers are super fun, but so you found ones with
people,
real money?
Mostly people winning a lot.
Oh, sure.
Or just be like big old towers. And then that at one point I did go on a thing, I'm like on YouTube, and you can see people, they'll post multi-hour videos of them doing this. But where they've just like, they just show up to wherever they are. Not a Dave and Buster's, I don't think. But maybe it is. I don't know. I've only been to one once. And honestly, that was nothing. And I just, I'm not middle class enough to be able to afford to go to Dave and Buster's more than once. I went to one for somebody's graduation party.
So the trick is to go on a Wednesday when everything is half price.
People need to just sign on to this just to hear all the deals that you know.
We can go into my Dave and Buster's days in more detail because it's stupid and interesting, kind of. So,
okay,
we can talk about that in a bit. But
all right, Dave and Buster's.
We can go into it now. The thing about Dave and Buster's is the thing that drove me really crazy was they all smell the same. If that makes sense.
Okay.
And, they use the same kind of like. Like air purifier scent, you know what I mean? Like,
I just remember it smelling kind of buttery all the time.
Buttery? It's like a tropical kind of scent. And so my sense memory, whenever I go into one, is just like, boom, remember? Remember, you dumbass, when you tried to be... So, okay.
And it's like what preschool smells like, but for you it's...
kind of, right, exactly. Or just any like high school, I feel like, has that smell, you know what I mean? Any school in general.
Another place I rarely went, so I don't know.
Oh, but
what that smells like.
For a long time, and I think they've since cracked on this significantly, Dave & Buster's had a lot of games that were winnable by skill. And I think the games are still winnable by skill. They've reduced the jackpots on the game significantly. But it used to be, there used to be a deal for, you pay $20, you get $20 credit. You go on Wednesday during half price game day. And then if you jackpot a certain amount of games before spending a certain amount of credits, you're essentially making a profit if you then buy a game. Like, they had video games there, so you would buy the game and turn it on eBay. Mm-hmm. And so I thought this would be a fun little side hobby. And did this.
It's rife with deals.
It's rife with deals. And I'm a bit of a gamer. I'm a bit of a professional gamer myself. Look at me. I'm on a stream Tuesday night playing a video game. So I know what I'm doing.
Sure.
I did. It's not that I didn't know what I was doing, but it was going to take a significant investment to get good at the games. And it was definitely possible to get good at some of the games.
Yeah.
A lot of them were kind of like carnival style skill, like not skill games where you would throw a ball into a milk bottle. You would throw balls to knock down like little goofy clown cat things. Oh, well,
I don't remember that at all, but I was the one time I went to Dave and Buster's, it was a graduation party. Mm-hmm. Dave and Buster's in North Austin is right next to, I don't remember what the actual name of the restaurant is because I always call it the wrong name, but it's like a big family style Italian chain. It's like Bippo de Beppo.
Buco
de Beppo.
Buco de Beppo.
That's it. Yes. It was very good. Mm. Went there.
Family style. It's like my favorite.
Friend's parents were paying for all the drinks.
Hell yeah.
And so I got Italian restaurant drunk and then went over to Dave and Buster's. Yeah. So my memories of it are rather fuzzy.
Dave and Buster's, yeah, it is what it is. You know what I mean? The food, I'll say this. Oh, that's the other thing is that, so I did end up getting a lot of tickets, even though I didn't win enough to like
make money.
I jackpotted a handful of games. There was one that, do you know Crossy Road? Are you familiar with Crossy Road? Mm-hmm. It was a mobile app that, a lot of their games are actually just mobile apps made. Flappy Bird, there's a Flappy Bird game.
Okay.
At Dave & Buster's. So I was very good at Crossy Road, and I jackpotted a bunch of times on that. Mm-hmm. And I found personally, because I'm me, that the thing I wanted most was like the free appetizer, free dessert coupons that you could get.
Like, we would have so much fun doing these stupid things together because I'm exactly the same way.
I wasn't interested in getting like whatever the latest PS5 game was or PS4 game. I wanted the Tower of Nachos, you know what I mean? Which are like $17. So if I win one 70-cent Crossy Roads game, then I just won a $17 appetizer.
And that's dinner. That's got to be a generous portion.
I mean, that's what one person's dinner was. When you're Rudy Basso, you order that and also the chicken wings and also the. So we'd be walking out with boxes of mediocre food, truly mediocre food, like the Applebee's quality, which is not a compliment.
No, that is the worst of the fern bars.
But again, it cost me like $5 total. So I still have something like 8,000 or 9,000 tickets on my power card. My power card, which is what which is what it's called.
Makes you feel big. It's the power card.
Exactly. It makes little kids feel like adults, I think. Yeah. Is the idea behind the power card. So
amazing.
Definitely there have been nights out where I've been like, hey guys, wanna go to Dave and Buster's for some shitty appetizers? And the answer has usually been no.
I would go with you. I'm quite sure I live hundreds of miles away from Dave and Buster's.
Yes. For a long time, they weren't any in New Jersey because of some weird law about games of chance. But then they opened a bunch of them up. So that was the other thing is that we were driving 40 minutes to New York to go to the Dave and Buster's. I made my brother go with me. So we would drive 40 minutes to a Dave and Buster's at this gigantic mall where I would get us appetizers and desserts. And then, like, I was doing algorithms. I had an Excel spreadsheet. Like, I was trying to really take it seriously.
That's amazing. I'm truly impressed.
It was fun too. At the end of the day, like I did have a good time doing it. There were some drives home that were like, "What is this? It should we be done?" And I think I did it maybe for 6 weeks.
Yeah.
And then I just was like, "No more. This has been an experience in my life. Like every Wednesday for 6 weeks.
Yeah.
It was an interesting way to use my day on a Wednesday, but I'm just not seeing the progress I want, and I don't care enough. If it was like down the street, maybe, whatever, but mm-hmm. I wasn't going to spend all that time driving.
Yeah.
Because that sounds absurd, and it is absurd. Yeah.
What do you want, kid?
Speaking of absurd, yes, we have to go gamble more.
Yes.
What's the next winning number going to be?
Voice, give me the password.
So you have to do this. Do you have to do the password again?
Yeah. What's this? I don't know if I have to do it. once or three times.
Right.
Just once.
The winning number two red.
Do we need 500 bits pieces of eight? Is that how much we're gonna need? Can you tell me that much? So
it doesn't say specifically how much we need.
All right.
But it's basically you want to gamble to the point where you get everything.
Oh, okay.
You can get everything.
Here's one piece of eight. I'll do that.
Yeah.
Okay. Kid.
Hopefully it's not too
much. Which number you want?
Two red.
I'd like two red.
Do you want to talk about biscuits while we do this then?
I do want to talk about biscuits.
Yeah. So the reason I showed Emma earlier, there's a recipe for sausage and biscuits that I'm really excited about that is through Vice. I don't know. Have you ever looked at Vice's recipes or?
No, this is the first one that I've looked at.
So one of my favorite celebrity chefs, Matty Matheson. Do you know him?
Big,
loud, tattooed Canadian guy. He's great.
Okay.
He's so funny. I love his shows. He's got one recipe for chorizo lasagna that is in my repertoire now because it's super good.
You can have a free pass
really,
to see the
chorizo lasagna. It's a killer.
Which will it be?
He used to be on Vice. He had a TV show. Now he does his own thing. They kind of get like edgier, I guess. Or they're New York based, so a lot of times it's New York. Small restaurateurs.
Well, I'm out of money for today. You're lucky that you won the last of it.
Okay. Congratulations. But yeah, so this they had a chef on. She was
Big
her name is Adrienne something.
Just one piece of eight.
She was on Top Chef a couple years ago. I remember really liking her on Top Chef, and she had a recipe that uses a couple things I'd never heard of. The one specific thing being Wondra flour.
Yes, Wondra flour.
Wondra. W O. N D.
What's the next
one? W O N D R A.
Yeah. So Wondra flour.
Yes.
You want me to tell you about it?
Yes. Oh, I'd love to do it.
Yeah. So Wondra flour is one of. I believe it's a product of like the 1960s.
Interesting.
And it was made for like easy thickening and like no clumping. It was supposed to be like easy baking stuff. Essentially what it is that it's water, it's flour that's already been
cooked, right?
Cooked.
Yes.
Yeah, so that the starches have gelatinized and they're going to surround the protein.
Yes.
And
I wasn't paying attention to what number
create something a lot more tender. You can make certain kind of cakes with Wondra flour. They work really well, like chiffon cakes. Like a lot of 60s stuff.
Yes.
Works well with Wondra.
So that's fascinating because in the recipe, I forgot what the number was, so I'm just going to go with 19 red.
I'd like 19 red.
She makes a roux because it's biscuits and gravy, and she uses the Wondra flour for that, which makes complete sense based on what you've told me.
Yep. So that's what you use it for. And I'm really happy. I was prepared to judge your biscuits.
My biscuits?
Your biscuit recipe.
Okay.
Because most biscuit recipes are very, very simple and they have a lot of problems because a lot of them come from their old-timey, like, grandma's recipe from the South.
You know what I mean?
So, and like, proportions are always kind of a difficult thing.
It's not just proportions, but it's also the fact that Southern wheat has 4 to 6% less protein than Northern wheat.
Really?
Yes. And so if you try to make something that's meant to be tender with wheat that we can get up here, it's not you're not going to get your result.
Fascinating.
What's the next winning number going
to be? So I was happy to see that because I was actually prepared to recommend something like sub half of it for cake flour or Wondra or to take out 20% of the flour completely and replace that with cornstarch.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
That's a way to compensate for the tenderizing. If you can't get like white lily flour, which is a southern flour, usually it's self-rising.
Oh, really?
But you can get non-self-rising white lily.
One piece of eight.
That's going to be, that's your first sort of hurdle. Because it kind of doesn't really matter how gentle you are with it. It doesn't really matter how much you
just
adhere
texture,
to the technique
the
because
it's never going
to
be there.
The flour is going to fuck you.
Yeah. Clip it.
I've made biscuits in my day. I lived in Texas for 16 years. Mm. Kind of. kind of. My recently dearly departed grandmother-in-law taught me how she made her bits. They're wonderful. But yeah, I think that this recipe is pretty good because she freezes the butter. She grates it, which is a way of making... Like, if you're going to make, like, what's called rough puff pastry, which is puff pastry that you're not actually laminating, you do the same technique, because it creates some layers. It's not going to be layers through the entire thing, but it's going to make flakes.
Yeah, curls, she calls them a lot in the video, or flakes, yes. A friend of mine recommended using a food processor instead of a box grater, because your hand will warm the butter up. Over time,
I mean,
and it's a faster way to just get that same kind of
it is,
broken
and like
texture
the
and quicker.
Yeah, the friction of that is going to heat
true.
It up well.
I don't have like a Cuisinart or something. I have a pretty shitty food processor.
It doesn't need to be a super strong one to be able to do this, really. But like, I actually use the food processor for a lot of different things in baking wise. Brother. Like that's how I do most of my like pie crust.
Sure. Just skip the kneading and go straight to the
And British style scones where you work the shit out of it.
Sure. I mean
that's the secret.
Yeah. I do pizza dough all the time, and one of the recipes I go to has hand a bowl mix, what is it called again?
Bowl like a
stand mixer.
Yeah.
Or food processor. And in fact, sometimes this is Kenji. He recommends the food processor first, which is interesting. So anyway, I got the Wonder Flour. I got the buttermilk, which is another one of the ingredients that you don't use often because it's funky.
I use it all the time, but I bake all the time.
Yes, exactly. It's not something, like, you hear buttermilk. It's not something you drink on its own.
Yeah. And for, no. Sound. Well, unless you're my mother who drinks buttermilk, and that's
really
horrifying. Yeah.
It's just so.
What if I can rent this one?
She like it's tang is like milky
tangy,
but tangy.
Yes, milky but tangy. Like you can. I mean, alternatives often use whole with a dash of vinegar or something like that.
Yeah, kind of. that's what I do in things that have other flavors. Mm-hmm. If I don't have any buttermilk.
Excuse me.
So if I'm making like the chocolate cake that I usually make has buttermilk.
Sorry, you can't help.
But I'll do like the sour milk technique with that because like there's chocolate and stuff. It's not really. It's there to acidify the batter, not to create flavor. But for here, like you need the buttermilk. You need it. You must have it. But yeah, it seems like it's a good recipe. Like, because the other thing I look for was stuff like this. Little bit of sugar.
Can I put the link in chat?
I don't do that.
Can we do that? 3 hours. Do you have the link on you?
I do. I can.
In chat. Again, this is Vice's biscuit and gravy. It came out like a week ago, I think, the video. Fun video. She's great, too. Adrian, in the video, does a great job explaining what she's doing, why she's doing it, and why it works.
I hear somebody swallow.
Which is very fun. I hope she gets a show.
Yeah. I wouldn't put sugar in my biscuits, but... That's just me.
Yeah, she does like a she does a honey butter glaze too.
That's a lot of sugar.
Yes, for a savory. I don't know if I'm gonna do that. Honestly,
I personally wouldn't. I don't like sweet.
Yeah,
biscuit.
I don't have honey either. I have some really nice maple syrup, so I was gonna do like a maple butter glaze instead.
That'd be better than honey. I think.
Yeah,
honey. I feel like it just blows the palate.
I think you're right. It can be very clean.
Yeah, but it's got that. It's got enough salt, which is also really important. Most biscuit recipes are undersalted.
Oh, fascinating.
Most of the time. It's got enough leavener. It's got enough.
Shit. I gotta see if I have baking soda. I know I have baking powder, but I don't know if I have baking soda.
Okay, yeah, you can't fake that one.
Yeah,
you gotta have it.
Back to the store and get that too.
And that's important because when you have buttermilk that's acidifying, you need to have some baking soda to balance it out.
Come on, don't be shy, let it fly.
What's the word?
Now I'm looking at the gravy, which I haven't looked at before.
So she makes her own sausage in the video. I just grabbed a tube. Gotta get that tube of Jimmy Dean's.
Her sausage isn't going to be very good because it starts with ground pork.
Yeah.
Like, it's just not gonna be.
What?
Like,
what's this? You're not a fan of ground pork sausage?
I love ground pork sausage, but ground pork sausage has about 35% more fat in it than a ground pork that you buy. you know?
Oh, so she adds butter to her recipe specifically to help with that ground pork imbalance.
Not gonna do it.
Not gonna do it.
It's not the right kind of melting point. It's not gonna. No, it's that the structure of butter and the structure of animal fat are different. Mm,
yeah, so lard would be a better alternative. Or
yes, I've actually done that.
Bacon fat, if you can get
bacon some of that. Fat, you can do. So like, I've made my own sausage a lot. I used to make it in restaurants, and so one thing that I would do sometimes is we would get ground pork that was special from like a local farmer, they'd put a little bit of extra fat in it for us because we used it for a lot of different things, and so it was fattier than normal but wasn't quite sausage fatty. And so we would get like leaf lard and trim, and we would grind that together along with it, and because it's cheaper to buy just the straight up ground pork. But I've made it myself at home. Last time I did was at Thanksgiving. I made my own sausage for my stuffing, because stuffing's the most important part of Thanksgiving.
Stuffing giving is what my friend James Andricasso had recently.
I know he does. I'm jealous. It sounds great. But I did that, and I ended up getting just a little bit of leaf lard and a little bit of just rendered lard.
Mm-hmm.
Because for that, it's like I'm breaking it up into little bits anyway, and I suppose you are for the sausage gravy, but to me, that's my critique of this, is that this needs more pork fat.
Gotcha.
That would be my only thing I would say.
Yeah, it's otherwise, just lard sometimes can be hard to find. Vegas Lancaster bought sticks of lard at the store, like sticks of butter that I had never seen before.
Oh, manteca. Yeah.
Yeah, he was like, oh, it was in the quarter.
Check it out.
Yep.
I'm like, oh, I'll have to get some of that. Yes.
You can usually find it in Mexican grocery stores or in the Mexican section of the grocery store.
International section.
I'll tell you what's gross.
What do I do?
So did you win everything?
I won everything from the guy. I've got it.
Okay.
All.
Now this set. Now I say go to Booty Island.
I'm on Booty Island.
Okay. Go to the antique shop. Yep. It's like the first shop you see on the left when you get to Booty Island.
Mementos, souvenirs, artifacts.
Oh, I can go in this? What the hell? I didn't even realize. I thought this was... Oh, my goodness. Okay. Well, all right. Hold off on the... Ooh, look. Let's see this in the nice version. That's kind of fun. I like the parrot. I like the way he looks in the modern version. Do you see this?
I love how all parrots look. It's like Iago. It's like a Iago-esque parrot.
He does look like Iago.
Which is the only Disney reference I will ever make.
Oh, okay.
I apologize.
It says, beware of parrot.
I'm an adult. I like movies that aren't Disney.
That's fine. You can like Disney. There's nothing wrong with
I'd
Disney.
Like to buy this well-polished old
song. It's all right. It's, no, it's not.
Oh. Okay.
I'd better save my money.
I have a child who's been way into the... early 2000s Mickey Mouse Funhouse.
Oh.
And I hate it.
That collectible plate is worth
I
a
hate
mint.
It. We wow. introduced him to Pokemon one day. I was just told that in part so he would stop watching this fucking show.
It's going to be a lot.
It's gross. I'm going to spare my socio-political rantings for another day.
Okay.
But
we'll do that.
I feel like it's the first step towards radicalizing
he likes it where it
young,
is.
The youth, to being white power loving
sure.
Nazi.
Yes. Oh my goodness. Okay.
That's kind of how I feel about it. Anyway,
I'm in the antique shop. It looks like I can buy all sorts of stuff.
Buy all of it.
Buy all of it?
Buy okay. all of it. Buy anything you can.
I'm starting to buy. Buying this
saw. I'd like to buy this well-polished old saw.
Great! That'll be 25 pieces of 8.
Okay, I'll take it.
Okay.
I'd like to buy it.
Thank you.
Got that.
Can you buy
I'd like
the
to
parrot?
Buy these cannonballs.
I just couldn't part with those. They have sentimental value. Sorry, he's not for sale.
He's not for sale.
I'd like to buy these hubcaps.
I see you have an eye
I'm
for quality.
I'm buying hubcaps.
They're 50 pieces of 8 each.
Okay. I'll take
okay,
it.
Okay, I'll take
buy
it.
All the shit.
Let me get you one from Overstock.
Buy it from that elf.
Here you go.
He does look like an elf.
He does.
He looks like a gnome in the 3D version, I would say. It's giving off big gnome vibes. Yeah.
He does.
I'd like to buy this map piece.
Or halfling
six
vibes.
6 million pieces of eight.
Yes.
Hobbit vibes. It? Little pirate
can't afford that much.
Too bad.
Wow, that is too expensive. The,
Yeah, like 6 million.
6 million.
That's one of my favorite things in the store.
Let's see, can you buy the mirror?
Oh. No, he said he likes it. The parrot likes it. What's that ship's horn? Can I buy that?
I'd like to buy this ship's horn.
Okie dokie. That'll be 40
pieces
of eight.
Combine it. Ship's horn.
Okay, I'll take it.
Mm-hmm. Let me get you one from Overstock.
Let's see. What's behind? We got
here
eye patches. I'm going to buy
Thank
one
you.
Of those.
Maybe.
I'd like to buy these eye patches.
I just keep those here because they're cool. They're not for sale.
I think
Is that Elvis?
It is, yeah. It's a
Can we
rock
buy
and roll.
Elvis?
That collectible plate is worth a mint.
You say it's worth
like
a mint.
I'd like to buy this rock and roll collector's plate.
Excellent choice. That'll be
199. I think
eight.
I have enough for that.
Okay,
yeah.
I'll take it.
I'll take it.
Let me get you one from Overstock.
You buy the hubcaps?
Here you go.
I bought a hubcap.
Thank you.
Good.
This is very silly. The rock and roll collector's plate.
Get the hubcap.
Peg leg? Let me see if I can get that.
I'd like to buy this peg leg.
Yeah, I like that too. But it's not
for
sale.
That's not
for
sale. What's this sign?
It says, beware of parrot.
Beware of parrot. I think I've bought everything. There's a mask up there?
It looks like Skippy the Pinhead.
Well, I'd like to buy this mask.
Yeah, I
beware
like that
of
too. But it's not for sale.
Indy's
I'd like to
whip?
Buy Indy's whip.
Yeah,
Indy's
like
whip.
Too,
not
but
for
it's
sale.
Not for sale.
I'd like to buy these gross skulls.
I just couldn't part with
Why
those.
Why does he have so much
they
stuff
have
he refuses,
sentimental value.
He refuses
I'd like to buy these pirate hats.
Excellent.
Okay,
I mean, like, clearly, like, we, it wasn't even clear that this place was a store. Clearly,
yeah,
this guy is not interested in. He has a questionable model.
Yes.
Over here.
Okay.
What'd you buy?
I bought the pirate hat. So I've got a mix of a whole bunch of different things.
All right.
I wonder if I can put it together in a costume.
Maybe you can.
I have a thing about lice.
You can use the ship's horn to blow.
Hey,
oh.
Take that thing outside, will ya?
I have an idea. I'm gonna spook this old man, and he's gonna fire the cannon.
Oh. Wait, you should go back in there. We haven't bought anything.
Oh,
yet.
Hold on. I'm gonna spook this old man.
Okay. That's always worth waiting for.
That sounds like the mailboat. I'd better fire the cannon.
He's firing the cannon.
Nice.
Boom. That ought to do it. Of course, I don't see no mailboat.
Okay, that didn't... Oh.
Did it hit your ship?
No.
Well, where's the mailboat?
People are coming over to ask about the mailboat. Okay. That was interesting. But,
okay.
All right, so I know that happens, but I don't know what it means. Maybe I need to grab a cannonball somehow. Mm-hmm. He said he wouldn't sell
like
me the
cannonballs
before.
Actually, those belong to my son.
I think you should try to buy the parrot sign first.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'd like to buy this sign.
I know you tried to again.
Sorry, that sign.
I know you tried to before, but try it again.
Well, I guess I could sell it. That'll be 5 pieces of 8.
Okay.
Okay, I'll take it.
All right. Sweet.
Thank you. Beware of parrot.
Beware of parrot sign. Do I have a pen or something? I'm very confused, Adventure Emma.
Do you have a empty bag of parrot chow anywhere? You do.
Does it Oh.
Yeah.
I don't want to make that parrot mad.
Oh.
The bag is empty.
Not there.
I'm making a confused face.
Perhaps there's a hook that you can...
Oh.
Hook it upon. I see it there.
He walked over and he looked at... I like the parrot. The parrot's my favorite character so far.
I'd like to buy this mirror.
Yeah.
Okie dokie. That'll be right. 15 pieces of eight.
Now you can maybe get the mirror.
Okay. Have it.
I'll take it.
I've purchased the mirror.
Wait.
Thank you. That is a nice looking beard. That is a nice looking beard.
Interesting. The text doesn't match what he actually says.
Interesting.
I like the parrot.
I'd like to buy this small picture frame.
That's one of my favorite things in
okay.
the store.
Right.
but I don't have enough back stock.
All right. So, it seems as though we probably
Soiled
have
the King's Image? That is a bunch nice looking stuff. Beer.
We have a bunch of stuff.
Mhm. Oh. So, we bought all that stuff. Go to
I don't think
the
I should
costume
check that.
Shop.
Okay.
Cuz if you look at the invite, I think there might be some information on it that's relevant.
You are cordially invited to Governor Marley's Mardi Gras blowout. Don't forget to bring this invitation when you pick up your complimentary costume. Please present invitation at door and wear your costume. That doesn't seem to work.
Sometimes it's like,
you have a costume on reserve.
You know, the game's.
Well, that's a different story.
Mm-hmm.
We need to make it longer. We need to make it longer. How do we do it? Okay.
Here.
It's just, there are times when it doesn't really like complete a satisfying game loop, right?
Yeah, well, exactly.
Where it's not rewarding you for discovery.
I don't feel like I've
and enjoy your costume.
Earned the costume. I feel like I missed something because I didn't.
Yeah, it's, I think I liked these games when I was a child because if you just use all the options with all of the objects, then you're probably going to win.
Yeah.
Glass bottom
and
boat.
That meant that I could do it.
Yes.
You know?
Like, you're a kid who
to me that you guys
doesn't,
are at least as
I mean, has the patience
llamas.
To just keep doing stuff over and over and over.
I
and over
hear
again.
There's some so, scouts here.
Because that sense of reward, you know, it comes from your kid brain, so that's pretty exciting.
Yeah.
Like, you did it. It's exciting for me. I won. Whereas now I'm like, well, what the fuck?
Yes. All right. Let's do this.
Got our costume, which is a dress. Tee-hee-hee.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned a party before?
Did you bring a costume?
I have my costume right here.
Put it on.
Better put it on.
Well, if you insist.
You mentioned a party.
No, not here. Go in the bushes.
It's a beautiful dress. I wish I had
it's
a dress.
It's a very nice dress. Yeah. It's very summer, which works
Jeez.
For the Caribbean.
A-line works this figure.
Oh, that is
like,
nice.
And you're all set.
The boots are a nice touch.
Oh, the boots are a nice touch.
Okay. I guess you can go through. Have fun.
Well, one of my favorite things in the game is coming up. Ooh, this is kind of creepy. Which is, there's a character. Where do I go? How do I follow this path? Oh, okay. This is so nice, like this outside path, and you walk over a, like, we'll see this in the new version. I do like the music. Oh, there's a dog!
Aww.
I like that. I like the dog.
Doesn't she have, like, several poodles in the previous?
She does, yes. Aww, they're like a vicious thing. Attack poodles or something like that.
I
remember they have a specific, like.
Yeah, and then you drug them.
Yes, you do.
It's good time.
With a fish, I believe.
Love any game. Yeah, it's like a fish that you've like infused with the flower you're not supposed to pick.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
What is all the racket?
This is my favorite.
Don't mess with the governor's cans. Who do you think
This chef just comes out and yells at you and follows you around to yell at you when you, because you like
punk.
Push.
And they make a boob joke.
Teenage vandals.
What?
Don't mess with the governor's cans.
Here.
It's a boob
I'm
joke.
I'm not done yet.
I thought it was a boob joke. Maybe it's not. Maybe I'm reading into things.
Maybe.
Yes, this isn't Leisure Suit Larry.
You have me. Get.
Which is not a game that could be made now.
Oh, no.
Did you ever?
No, I never. I mean, I never was really interested in those. I just love the music too. And he gets mad because you push the garbage can. It's so funny.
It's so mean. You got some nerve.
Oh, he's... What the heck? He's teleported.
Get you on staff only!
Sorry.
That's okay. I just wanted to go in there to do that part, but we can go into the...
Mm-hmm.
Into the party. And I believe this is as far as I've ever gotten in my
replay
of this. No, I've beaten the game when it was just Monkey Island 2, but I've never done the special edition. I think this is about as far as I got.
Does it have different plot lines and stuff?
No. I just forgot and was like, meh. Okay, I know I have to go upstairs somehow.
Oh, where are all the chicks?
I think there's like a ton of dialogue here too, where the
I feel like I remember this.
To Elaine Marley.
Oh,
looks like
that's right.
To Big Whoop.
These guys
this
just
great party.
These guys
to
just
the
toast
party.
Everything over and over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
It's very
to
funny.
The salmon
part of the map to Big Whoop.
Tea.
He's got one. The antique shop dealer has one.
Yes.
Yeah.
So let's see if I can find
a way to get it. Women I've loved before.
Oh, okay.
Thanks.
You just snag it. Well, I got the first. That's map pretty piece. Easy. Oh, and it's actually a map that I look at. Neat.
I'm gonna sweat up 20 pounds in this stupid costume.
Yeah, I thought there'd be some here. And again, these costumes. Who can tell?
They seem to be enjoying the party.
I need to.
There might be some babes here.
Get the fish.
And let's have one for the Jolly Roger.
We need to get the fish.
They're already picked clean.
I need to get the. Or Roger. Maybe not. I need to get upstairs somehow, which means I have to distract these guests. I don't remember how to do that.
No kidding.
I have to do something else in the. Do something with the dog.
Matter, boy? Smell something?
Yep. Well, get the fish. You mean from the kitchen?
Yes.
Yes. Apparently, I think there is a way if you're quick enough.
This crazy mutt is trying to kill
me.
That's what it seemed like because he was running around and you had some liberty in what you did, right?
Gotcha. Yes.
Yeah.
Mr. Threepwood, take me to the governor right away.
This dog is barking.
Just
at
me. About to.
I love that dog. A basset, like a basset first, hound, is
you empty your
on my list of dogs me, I would man. Like to have. And Jim Davis, who is my partner in business and life, is not on board.
No basset hounds. They're pretty silly looking. They're pretty
look out
silly
for that
looking.
Rake.
Yeah, they are. But that's why I love them.
Okay, I'm upstairs. Or it's,
Governor?
Oh, there's a.
I caught one of your party guests making off with your grandfather's map.
Okay.
Oh, so you knocked your. Oh, treasure hunter, eh? Letting Elaine bring him in.
Oh, that sounds like the same Elaine.
In here,
Guybrush.
Guybrush.
Or she did escape.
Guybrush. Three foot?
Yeah, cool. She's got that kind of funky
one
sort
and
of.
Only sugar bear.
Of all the parties in all the houses.
Sort of British
all
accent.
The
it's like
of
all
the
over
Caribbean,
the place. I love it.
He had to crash mine.
Oh.
It's destiny, honey cakes.
Don't talk to me.
Snugglepuss.
Get lost.
That is not what I expected her to sound like in my head, because I never played it with voice actors. I expect her to have like a silvery posh.
We haven't been like this since.
Yeah, it's like.
Since I quit my job and moved.
Like a fancy Cockney accent, I'd say.
Is that what
it's like a weird bastardization of both of those. Like a posh and Cockney combination.
I thought we had.
Yeah. Yes, it is. Hey, glad you love the game. We love it too.
Sweater.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Same old Guybrush.
They're good times. So yeah, I'm back to your biscuits beer? And gravy.
You
this sounds great. I assume you've made
this
gravy
isn't a
before.
Game store.
Fine. Be that way. There are other fish
like
in the
southern style
yeah,
gravy.
Even fish have
standards. Oh, I mean, gravy is gravy.
Oh yeah. I've definitely made a grave in my day.
Yeah,
I've done some
roughly the same.
Let's see. You know, we've talked about the reverse sear.
You just asked.
Mm-hmm. Kenji's recipe. He also had one to make gravy with. With that, where you, am I back
maybe
in here?
I wasn't clear enough the last time.
You know, you have a raised rack that you put the beef on, your prime rib, your whatever.
That way.
And underneath maybe that, you put a bunch of other different cuts that are, you know, rich in collagen. So I think it's like oxtail and short ribs. And then you use the drippings from that to help make a gravy. Along with your veg. And I've done that before, and it honestly maybe wasn't really worth it. That's the thing, is like...
It sounds like a fantastically expensive way to make gravy.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Yes, it definitely was like, this is... I mean, it was Christmas or whatever. It was a holiday.
Oh, yeah.
So we went all out, and it was one of those things where it was like, this probably wasn't worth it.
Yeah, like I make gravy with my big roast without any extra bits.
Yeah, you don't need you don't really need that much, and I'll go to bat for the powdered gravy. I'll go to bat for it.
It's not terrible.
It's not terrible. It's better than jarred, I say. I think jarred gravy's weird. But I recently went to Boston Market for the first time in a very long time because there was a half off family meal deal that I found.
It's a beat up metal trash can.
So
take notes, everybody.
My brother and I went to Boston Market, and they didn't give us gravy, which sounds absurd to me.
Boy.
And we had mashed potatoes. We had all the stuff. There should have been gravy.
Should have been gravy.
So I had a packet of just brown gravy.
Don't even think about going in there.
It was great. it works perfect.
Think about going in there.
I'm
this neighborhood has really gone down.
It works. I mean, bots and market gravy, that's coming from a powder at some point.
Yes, absolutely. No. You're 100% like, right.
And it's good. I my closest big city in the US is Boston, and so I feel as though I'm obligated to enjoy Boston market.
Boston market. It's fine. Everything's fine. If it wasn't half off, I'd be like, Jesus, we just spent $50 on this, but it was half off, so.
Yeah, it's like acceptable. It's better than work. like a microwave turkey dinner.
Yes, it's kind of wild that the rotisserie chicken is so prolific in the United States these days at your grocery stores, at your Costco's and things like that. And it was one of those things where it's like, used to be, if you wanted this, you had to go to Boston Market. Now you go to any grocery store and you pay like $6 and you get one.
Innocent
so.
People's trash.
What Costco.
It's true. Shut off. Special.
Lost leaders.
Yep.
What am I supposed to do?
Okay. So.
You said if I was fast enough, I could grab something.
If you can make a full circle all the way around, you can enter the door before it catches you.
Okay. Let's do that then. I think I can. That's.
I know you can.
I love the music and the chef. It's so funny.
Yes, just have to annoy the chef until he makes a mistake.
You again? What's the matter?
And then you go and steal his fish.
I said, scram!
Jesus, you're the clearer.
He's so mad at you.
Excuse me.
Vamoose! Try sticking your head in a cannon if you like loud noises.
Excuse me.
You are excused. Yeah, so I'm gonna do. I gotta make meatballs tonight because I'm gonna do meatball pizzas.
Nice.
That's exciting. Alright, I'm in.
Sweet. Get the fish.
Got the fish.
Sweet.
Is there anything else in here I need? Seems like no.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I think it's just the fish. Can I walk to the front? No, I'll just walk out the way I came in then.
Oh.
Oh, there
can
you
pick up the dog?
Anyway, like I was saying, don't let me catch you hanging around the governor's party either.
Can I pick up the dog? The dog's name is Guybrush, like me. Yeah. My name's Guybrush.
Just like you. I don't know who you're referring to as man-child because I treat my spouse with respect. But
me,
or you mean my son? Oh. A little bit. Sorry.
Okay, that also can apply to me. That term probably.
You make gravy. You're not a man child.
Okay, that's it. Ah,
no, my
Let this be a lesson to you.
I'm rather sleepy. Yes, because my boys.
I picked up the dog.
His brain is growing. Yes, you picked up the dog. He's right next to the fish.
That doesn't seem to smell interesting to him.
Either your cousin or his offspring.
Oh, what a cute boy. Oh,
yeah. You're one of the Davis boys.
Oh, how about that?
Nice. Yeah. No, he's doing that a little bit. It's also 8:50 in the evening, and for me, that's...
To the land!
That's time to start yawning. That's just the way it is. I wrote...
I'm also yawning. I get it.
Nice to see. Is that are you Paul?
I have a thing about lice.
Yeah, I wrote the last chunk of our book
yesterday. Yay!
And probably don't have to look at it until layout. And now comes all the fun stuff where we get to order the samples of the extra merch that were addons. So we've got like two kinds of dice and a dice bag, a DM screen. Somebody thought it would be a really fun idea to have a flask with our logo on it. And so there's going to be a flask. Did I lose you?
No,
you
I'm
there?
Here. Sorry.
You're there. Okay. Yeah. So the flask, we get to like order a sample.
Two kinds of dice, right? Two kinds of dice?
There's two kinds of dice. There's wasteland dice and there's weird dice. And the wasteland dice are like pretty stone and the weird dice are multicolored metal. And I kind of think they look like Juggalo camo, but everybody likes them, so I'm gonna go with it. And
I'm yawning. This is you did this to me.
That means that we're connected. Did you know that?
if we both yawn at the same time?
Yeah, when you're around people that you like, and one of them yawns, you're more likely to yawn yourself.
Oh, maybe so, but it's still shiny and sharp.
Mm-hmm. It's a thing. But yeah, so we're at the point now where we get to look at all the stuff, and I don't have to look at the book again until it's laid out, and I'm very excited about that, and also a little sad, because I've really enjoyed
writing the book.
But that's also why I'm tired.
Yes.
Because there's one thing I've learned about game design and writing.
It's fatiguing.
You know, there's a lot of decisions to make.
Yeah. Your brain far is more on. Than... You know what I mean? Your brain. It's not just the thing you just... Some people can, I guess. Just sit down and go. But you got to be thinking about words when you write them words.
There's a lot of like pre-work involved, but then it's for me, what I'm most aware of is that it's just, there are a lot of decisions that you make that mean a lot of things, especially if you're writing for D&D.
Sure.
And there's the style guide that you must adhere to.
Of course, yes. The style guide.
Yes. And so it's like, okay, so do I really want to go for a skill save here? There are these three different things I'm going to I'm going to think through. Mm-hmm. What are the merits of doing that? Is that really worth using up the word count for doing so? Is this something that, you know, really, does it have something interesting that happens if it doesn't work, for instance? Do I want to do those things? And if so, am I using the right words to indicate what I intend?
Exactly.
This may be your last.
Which is not the way I would word any of these things.
I know. It's not about... That's, you have to always think of who's thousands reading, right? You have to think of it as someone who's never heard of anything before is reading it. Which is always difficult.
We've made some modifications because we respect our...
We respect our
fans enough to assume that they're probably... This is probably not their first rodeo.
Yeah.
You know? But yes, absolutely. And depending on whatever we do next, there's a possibility that we will need to do more of that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. But yeah, there's just a lot of little decisions to be made about things.
Absolutely.
And on so many levels.
It adds up. And it does. Gets tiring. 100%.
It does. And this was a location. We've got eight locations in the book. This was the tier 4 location, which is fun because you get to be on your big brain bullshit.
I was gonna say, yeah.
But it's also hard because it's all your big brain bullshit.
Yeah, the amount of choice players have at that point.
In some ways, that makes it simpler because all you have to do is really just explain what's there, and there doesn't need to be like. So I wrote.
Because there's many ways to approach it when they're at that point. You mean?
I ended up writing. I helped with this one. It was me and Jim. It was mostly Jim doing this one, but I wrapped it up. And then I wrote three others. So I've been involved in writing a location for each, intended for each tier, but you can return to them, obviously. And it's been interesting seeing, it's sort of like in the earlier tiers, like you really do need to kind of set up dominoes that are about to collapse.
Mm-hmm.
But the higher level you get, there's enough choice and you're assuming that these people are probably bringing their own like goals and points of view because they know their characters and they're doing all the stuff.
Sure.
So that just kind of like, it just has to be there. And it's like, what do you want to do?
Yeah.
Like, you can change a lot of shit. It's not that this thing is like going to go to shit if you do nothing.
Yeah, exactly. But
thousands will spit. And so in that way, it was sort of interesting.
Yeah.
And also it really like encourages, personally, it would encourage me as a designer to focus on the scenario and the narrative and not so much the mechanics, because the second you do that, it's going to collapse.
Yeah, exactly.
Into just infinite possibility. I can think of five spells that are going to completely fuck up this, you know,
you can't
this
that.
Little moment of tension that I that. Think yeah. needs to be here. So no, I wrote a bunch of encounters. Jim had all these notes, and
I learned recently. He's a handwritten guy.
He mostly is. This made it on the page to a certain extent. But there was one where it was just like, A trio of lich frenemies are in a bunch of cars that are just like driving across the wasteland. Where'd you want to go? And they all have different goals. And they're all trying to, in the most friendly way, just fuck everybody else. And so it's like, oh, so I get to think of this a little bit. Like, what are the implications of this? And why would an 18th level party give two shits about these people and what they're doing? And so it's cool stuff. He had a lot more than that, but I just love that it started. It was just like, lich frenemies. Okay, you're got it. I know exactly where this is going.
I'm up for a swing.
Nice try. Lich frenemies and cars. You're fired. That's we do have a lot of vehicles in this, and it's a good time.
It's a metronome.
Oh, you're back here.
Yeah, I decided to come back because I wanted to see if the monkey was here. He is.
Yeah. Wait, why is the monkey here? Did we put the monkey here?
No, it's one of those over. As you progress throughout the game, the monkey just appears.
Aww.
I don't want to get the monkey mad.
That's super sweet.
I don't want to get the monkey mad.
You're supposed to mess with the monkey for some reason.
And I never mess with the monkey.
The way you mess with him is you... Oh, there it is. He wants the banana.
Don't bug the monkey.
Oh, of course he does. He's a monkey.
I think you put the banana on the metronome. Yes.
Hey, what'd you do to my piano player?
Don't bug the monkey.
But what do I do now?
He's cute.
I just take him.
Can you pick up the monkey?
Just take him.
Can you pick up the monkey?
What kind of game is this?
Thanks for nothing, buddy.
Your pockets are endless.
Apparently, I have a fish and a dog and a monkey all in the pockets simultaneously.
This is the setup to a very elaborate and very dirty joke. I love it.
Oh my goodness.
So you got a monkey.
I've got a monkey. I've got a dog. I've got a fish. I've got a pirate hat. I've got a plate with Elvis's picture on it.
Isn't there there's on a different island, there's some dude who's fishing.
There is.
Yes.
Good call.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Did you want to show this guy up?
I'm just dying to see what you do with the Elvis plate. I have no idea.
Island. Yeah. And maybe we'll call it after this interaction.
Yes.
See what he says. Oh my goodness, time flies.
This hour has flown by.
Truly. All right, you little prick.
That doesn't seem to work.
Talking to the fisherman, I hope.
Yeah, the fisherman.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. This is the biggest.
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah. Well, he looks a lot like one of my good friends, and so I can't think of him.
Oh.
Really? Where is this Leviathan?
This guy.
I think you're lying.
Yeah, you're right. It was just a fish story. I guess you win. Here, take the pole.
All right, we got this fishing pole.
Sweet.
Good call. I completely forgot about that, Emma.
I remember these things.
You remember these things.
It is a nice pull.
Yeah.
It is a nice pull. All right, let's save it.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm about to yawn again. I don't know what happened. I just got hit by the fatigue wave.
It's probably because you ate a cookie for dinner.
It wasn't a cookie. It's a Bobo's Oat Bar.
It's bars are and cookies are often synonymous in many languages.
There's xanthan gum in this.
That's a binder.
It is a bummer.
Because it's a bunch of oats.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not cookies. Sweet.
All right. This was so much fun.
Yes. Always. 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 Fun to talk Bobos. Yeah. Fun to talk biscuits.
Mm-hmm.
Can't wait to see what we talk about next week. So thank you everyone for tuning in. Oh, tomorrow.
Yeah.
Tomorrow. Very exciting. Is going to be our first watch along.
Yeah.
On here. On using Prime. Well, I guess you have to have Amazon Prime Video to participate in that. I hope you do, dear viewer. We're going to watch Dudes and Dragons with Daisy Grant as a guest. Yeah. Yumi, Jim,
some quality cinema.
And, we'll see. I don't want to be overly negative, like mean negative, but we'll see. We'll see how it is.
Yeah. Yeah, so check
good,
it out.
Though.
Yeah. Check it out. Tomorrow. We're also...
Yep.
Yeah, we're going to be live on YouTube earlier that day, and
Jim
Davis is going to talk about the Radiant Citadel chapter that just dropped on the Indie Beyond.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool. Well, thank you, Adventure Emma.
Thank you, Assistant Rudy.
I will talk to you soon.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.